Okay, this is what I was thinking. I went to box seats the other day. Okay, my dad, his friend had box seats. We went to, like, this is very, like, these, you know what box seats are?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's very expensive. They're all rich, right? And I was thinking, there's a girl that was doing the cart for the desserts. This girl was so heavy, right? She was so fat. And I was just like, that is a waste of an opportunity. That's what I was thinking.
That's very
and
smart.
And I was like, I was running out of money. Yeah, I would go to the OnlyFans route. I go to the where the high value men. I would be like,
that's like the golf cart girls.
Mm-hmm. Look, I talked to this guy the other day. That there was like one of my 101 sessions, and he was telling me, like, sometimes people just like want to tell you stories on 101 set. I don't know, it was interesting. But he was telling me, he's like, girls go after the wrong rich guys. They go after the managers when the owners are the ones, like, they're average guys at these places. No girls really talk to them, and he's like, they're worth like 60, 70 million. I'm like, if I had to choose, I'd just go that route.
Well, it's an interesting question. Route, the sugar you know, daddy route, you got to put out the sugar. You know, a lot of times.
No.
I mean, that's a funny thing. A lot of times, it's much better to be on camera at the crib than putting out the
actual
sugar.
Hear me out. Okay. I just feel like you get a job that's the bar cart girl. Uh-huh. You're in the same room as all the guys worth 60 million.
Yeah.
It's not like that's that hard of a job to get, bar cart girl.
Uh-huh. No. But how are you going to get the $20,000 in 30 days?
You need 20K in 30 days.
Well, that's when she got her first month.
Yeah.
So that, you know, it's like you got to.
Yeah, I didn't think the plan all the way through.
You got to think it out.
I got to think it all the way through.
Yeah.
I think where I was at, because of emotionally, like my trauma and all of that, I actually looked older. And I think I'm, like, more in my prime now than when I was younger. Like, I looked tired and worn out and beat down. Like, you could see that, like, the world is wearing on me. And I don't think, like, the energy that I was putting out was conducive for me finding, like, mm-hmm. someone like that. Mm-hmm. It wasn't until now that I'm like, okay, like, I can dress like a lady. I, like, know how to hold myself and have, like, those conversations because OnlyFans allowed me to have that time to myself. And now I'm in those rooms where I'm starting to, like, meet those men and talk to that. But when I had no money, I didn't have any money to buy nice clothes, to, like, buy a nice dress and have the time off.
But you can't give up, right? You can't give up $20,000 a month.
Mm. Yeah. So I went on a date with, like, I don't know, you could term him as a sugar daddy. I met him at, like, a rich bar in Boston, like, in Back Bay. And he was like, I want to take you out. And I was like, okay, like, this guy's in a nice area. Like, why not try the sugar daddy route? That's when it was really being pushed on social media,
See?
I feel
How
like.
How old
like,
was he?
He was probably 40, but I was also 19. So, okay. Like, I was like, oh, he's so old. He must have so much money. And then we went on a date. He took me to a shitty fucking restaurant. I was like, oh, this dude's got no money. His Volvo had a busted out headlight. I was like, oh, man, I cannot choose him.
Worst sugar daddy ever.
Yeah. I cannot choose him. And
but
then
how did you determine that he was a sugar daddy just because he was 40?
Were you on a site?
I didn't know. I just guessed. I was like, oh, he probably has money. He, like, you know, he was in, like, the financial district. I go there, he's like, yeah, I want to have sex with no condom. I'll give you $100. And I was like, oh, Jesus Christ, Ashley.
Oh,
and that completely turned me off to sugar dating. I was like, no, thank you. I'm so good.
I really value, like, connection. Like, I really want to, like, feel connected. So, like, the money can't be the only thing.
$100 for raw sex? You got me fucked up.
So what was the number? Okay,
damn,
so what?
What's the number?
What was the right number then for raw sex?
I would be offended.
Taking
I
me
was
away
offended.
From it.
What was the right number?
200.
Oh, well, shit. I mean.
The right number now, after I think OnlyFans did make me feel more secure in myself, and I feel a lot more confident now. I swear, if you saw the change in, like, my photos and videos and how I carried myself, and not, like, even the OnlyFans stuff, I'm not gonna show you.
I would say the
news.
World that OnlyFans is able to provide.
Yeah, but, like, just, like, regular shit that I would post on social media, I feel a lot more confident, and I don't know where I was going with this.
You've just been
wait,
able to
you
grow.
Were tell
actually,
us the
actually, okay, wait. This,
I don't think all
this
OnlyFans
gonna,
girls
this
are taking
is,
that time to grow, though.
Sorry, question. Did you know before you started OnlyFans that, like, people might look at you a certain way?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
That was, I think a lot of people
like 20 grand a month, you're like, you, like
so wow. I was, so when I started it, I was like, okay, the pandemic is going to be, the day I had like broken up with the boyfriend and moved in with Emily, that day the pandemic started, like the lockdown. And that's when like the finance stuff was happening. And I ended up getting like discriminated against in my company by like my new sales manager. And one of my ex-best friends got mad I was making more money than her in sales and went to my boss and was like, she has an OnlyFans.
Wow.
And so I went through like basically a legal battle with my company for a couple months and I was like, this isn't gonna last. The job market's gonna be hard. My friend who had like no social, she was like, I made $700. Like, why don't you just try it? You don't have to do anything. And I was like, you know what? Like, wait. I won't show any show that much.
You didn't have an OnlyFans?
No, during this time. And so I was when I was deciding to start it, and I was looking at it, I was like, okay, I'll do it for 3 months. I'll become like the comedian on OnlyFans who does like topless comedy. I'll get the marketing out of that. I'll get a boost in my income, and I'll take that time to look for another job and like be in corporate America. But something like deep down was like, you don't want to be in corporate America. I'm good at sales.
Well, yeah, the money that you made said that you didn't want to be in corporate America.
The freedom, but I was also getting like $17,000 commission checks from being in sales. So like,
but you have to hump it though.
Yeah, it was so stressful, and so I was like, wow, I'm doing a fraction of the work and I'm making money. And once I started making like good money, I was like, oh, I took that as like, you have to dive in, because I sold marketing.
But see, y'all know y'all can't ever talk to a regular guy again, though, right?
I think there's a lot of regular guys who are okay with it. But I think like the ones that are your
I want a regular guy.
Yeah. Right, right. Yeah.
But see, she's being real.
Yeah, she's
You can't talk to a regular guy though, right?
But what woman wants a regular guy?
Yeah. What is a regular guy?
You know,
like, how would you term that?
A guy that makes $60,000 a year, wants kids. You know, 401k.
Mm-hmm.
You don't want that guy.
No,
right?
I don't think I ever wanted a guy who is only making $60,000 a year.
What's the minimum threshold?
I don't know, because for me, it depends a lot on personality.
Oh no!
Yeah, maybe when you start off saying
$60,000,
and so when he says the number, you're like, oh well, his personality.
That's true.
The guy making $60 also had a personality.
Damn.
Right?
All right, you got me.
So those guys are the good ones. But if we're in media and are like we're doing that, you already need like a certain type of man that's going to handle with you being online and all the time. Cool. OnlyFans aside,
so
like if you're a social media person.
What do we need to make then?
They just need to be an entrepreneur, have
a good
track record.
That's not what she said.
So, Emily, okay, so what's my dollar limit, you're saying? Because
Just the floor. I mean, anybody like 30 million, yeah, but what's the floor?
I'd say like 120.
120.
Around there.
Mm-hmm.
What about you?
I would say I would want, when my dad was doing well, he was making like a decent amount, and that really did help our family.
Mm-hmm.
And based on like my biggest trauma is like the financial stuff. If you're making 60k a year, I already know, if we have, say we have three kids, you're making 60k a year, I'm not doing OnlyFans, so I'm working under you. You can't pay me to work under you. That's not enough for me to take away from having another job. And then there's not a lot of disposable income there. If something happened, we're in a recession, whatever happens, saving up for college, like 60K is not a lot in terms of having a...
What's the minimum?
I would say like 150.
So you want 20, you want 50.
Yeah.
So you want 150, but also you want a guy that is going to accept your OnlyFans pass?
I think with 150, if you're an entrepreneur, you're already a little bit more open to different ways of life.
Even if you're in corporate or finance or you're a surgeon.
No, they are not. I will tell you. No. I grew up in a family of entrepreneurs. All my brothers make six figures. None of them would take home an OnlyFans girl.
I feel like guys who are in more like boxed in jobs.
I'm like, all right, hold on now. But I mean, it just depends, I guess, like what they're saying, what's on the OnlyFans. If they've got content, like I'm a YouTuber, right? So if I make an OnlyFans and I've got some private YouTube videos that YouTube doesn't want me uploading because they're going to demonetize it, right? So I put it on OnlyFans. That's one thing. But, you know, I started unbuttoning my pants. Like, oh, hold up now. Hold up. So No, I mean, there's just so many other women out there, right? That's the only thing.
For sure.
There are women that, you know, and I'm not saying there's anything wrong, right? Because if you're getting 20 grand a month, it's like, hey, man.
Yeah.
You know, I'm
but
just,
that's also okay that that's your boundary, that you wouldn't want to date a woman who has shown
but,
that.
Yeah,
but also,
and like, there what are if? Porn stars that have husbands,
yeah.
right? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, they, I mean, you and I, we talk to. You and I talked to a YouTuber, and like he was like, you know, damn, his marriage, right?
Yeah, that was wild.
Yeah, so you know,
I want to be in on the secret. What happened?
I know.
There's this YouTuber. His name is Mr. Lucario, a well-respected YouTuber.
Oh, okay.
You know,
no,
like,
I know what that is. Yeah.
Does he do too?
No.
He has a.
He's in a
lifestyle. That's.
Let's say he's in an open marriage, and it's open on both sides. So, you know, if and they're happy, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, like, more power to them, right? But to regular guys like, you know, me and Anton, you know, we really can't imagine our wife going to her boyfriend's house, and then my wife is giving her boyfriend head. And then
coming home and kissing me.
Yeah, like when he's in her mouth.
Oh.
But that's my wife.
Oh, wow.
No.
Yeah,
that's
unless
crazy.
You're doing it together. I wouldn't
no,
want to
No, even
separate.
Then, like together or apart, there's no no
see.
One's coming in my wife's mouth. Like,
see,
is that, like there's no, all if it's together. No. There's none of like that.
You're like,
that's even worse.
Him to do it.
Because I'm watching it. I'm traumatized. Like, oh, no. See, that's
so
the thing.
I think being an OnlyFans, we learn a lot. Jeez. I have a lot of men, more men than you think, who are in like these roles and have like nice jobs or whatever. They feel because they can't talk to their women openly about like their kinks or what they want sexually, that they like, will seek OnlyFans girls to have those conversations.
Oh, I believe it.
And there's a lot of men,
but they're
who,
not
like,
marrying the OnlyFans. So that's
no,
thing.
But
correct.
They're dissatisfied in, with the girls that they're marrying because they're not.
They're
able
not dissatisfied.
To have that
they're
not
dissatisfied sexually.
No, see, which I don't understand about guys.
It's a lot of dissatisfied.
No, I agree that there are a lot of guys
sexless?
That are dissatisfied, but it doesn't necessarily.
What?
See, a guy can have multiple different women serving different purposes, and they don't necessarily need one woman to do everything in order for them to be satisfied. You understand what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So there are some guys that are in sexless marriages and stuff like that, so we're not going to ignore those dudes, right?
Yeah.
But my point is that you may. A dude may not want his woman to fit a certain fetish that he may have.
That's
but he
true.
May fulfill that somewhere else, but it doesn't necessarily mean that he's not satisfied with the role that she's playing.
Okay.
Yeah.
So a dude can have multiple different women fulfilling different purposes, and that's okay for that particular guy.
Mm-hmm.
But that doesn't mean he's not possessive about the fact that he don't want his girl to be with another dude.
Mm-hmm.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
Yeah.
I do think that that means that he is dissatisfied in his sexual relationship, which is all I was trying to say.
Or maybe he just has a robust sexual appetite that requires multiple different lifestyles or different women to fulfill it.
But what if you could have a woman that does all of that? Hits wifey and is kinky in the way that you want it specifically.
I think that if you talk to most men, considering that most men or a lot of guys are in sexless marriages, I think it's very rare for a dude to find a unicorn.
Mm. Why do you think a lot of men are in sexless marriages?
I think a lot of women marry their second choice, and then they get the kids, and then they just stop wanting to have sex with
them. Do you think men marry their second choice, though? Like, I feel like every man has their first love.
I
they fucked it up, she got away, and that still will always be their number one
I actually agree with you. I think a lot of guys marry their second choice, too. But I just think women, like, we can't really be satisfied with our second choice, third choice.
I'm not sure,
like,
guys.
Like, why do you think Titanic was such a hit? Think about it. Women love Titanic. They love The Notebook. Those are two female movies. Why do so many women identify with that? It's the one that got away.
I'm not sure.
You don't see
the push and pull. That's toxic back and forth that you don't know if you're going to have them or not. That keeps that alive.
I don't think that guys marry their second choice. I think guys get married earlier and then they evolve and grow to be better versions of themselves. Whereas the woman, in a lot of instances, she's already hit her peak and she's going down.
Mm.
And so it kind of is a thing to where he's growing and evolving and he's just now realizing his power. because he doesn't even realize that the best version of him is way later in life. And then it just turns into a thing.
I think a lot of people get married without actually considering who they are. And they get into these relationships early and they don't actually know who they are. They don't know what they want. And then they get out of relationships and they're like, oh my gosh, I can blossom. I can actually be who I want to be. I can actually go for the sex that I want to have.
That doesn't work for y'all. That don't work for women. That doesn't work for women.
In what way?
Because you're at your peak when you're younger.
See, I feel like I'm at my peak now. If I showed you a transformation photo of what I looked like, I don't think I would have gotten the time of day for a lot of people.
I'm curious. I want to see.
A peak based off of what guys desire in women.
And what do men desire in women?
In marriage?
Mm-hmm.
The first thing that they desire is that not a lot of guys have been with their woman.
Okay, so exclusivity.
100%.
Yeah. Anton, let's be real. Let's be real. Looks is first. A guy would take. Okay, hear me out.
Not to marry though. It's a lot of guys that's married.
Can I get it for a second?
Go ahead.
So a guy is gonna take, let's say, OnlyFans, corn, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
120, over a 320 girl, 320 pounds.
Yeah, but that's a huge gap.
No, I know. There's some variability in the middle, but to get in the door, you have to have a base level of looks.
I agree.
To get in the door, that's why I said looks is first, because if. Yeah, that has to get you in the door. Guys aren't as picky.
a lot of guys, though, earlier.
That's my fate, everything.
A lot of guys earlier in their life, though, they married a person that they...
Like, I'm 29, I'm glowing now.
They're in close proximity to.
You look the same.
Why did you look like that, though?
No, because I was saying she looks, like, the same to me.
Well, I'm, like, 40 pounds lighter, so that's just my face. But I look tired. I wasn't, like... I don't know.
You just got red hair.
You think I look like that right now? Don't insult me like that. Come
on. You look like tired with like no makeup. Like, that's what
I think.
No,
it, like,
you look better now.
That's right? Good. I think I'm like glowing. I think
Lead is the playboy. So you.
Oh my god.
Lead. So you like how I look?
Lead is the playboy.
I want to see where like I was heavier too, and I'm 5'2", so it.